Absolutely. And, you know, one of the things that Johnny and I have felt for us that's helped us raise our self-awareness is creating and putting content out there. So not creating the selfie, but actually trying to inform and add value and add to the conversation, it creates an actual loop of conversation and feedback to you to grow and realize, hey, this podcast episode didn't hit the mark, or hey, this video wasn't as impactful as we thought, versus the selfie, me, 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 doesn't often create that feedback loop for us. And I've noticed, especially in a work from home situation, that many of us are not taking the time outside of these Zoom meetings to share that external bit of feedback. So, you know, oftentimes, even when we were working in the office and we saw a team member down or something going on that we would pick up on, you know, you pull that member aside and ask and check in, is everything okay? But now in this Zoom world, it's like hop from call to call. There's less of that momentary relief and feedback that can help someone else grow or just show the empathy needed to really help them deal with this. And
that's exactly right.
The other piece to this that I think is really fascinating is self-view. So we went from a place of being in the room together, having no mirror image of ourselves to look back at and say, okay, how am I being presented, and all of the self-loop that goes on there and self-talk. And now we're on Zoom and many of us have that self-view there and we're staring right back at ourselves while we're in these meetings.
It's awful.
And I think it's leading to this false sense of self-awareness. Like, oh, I'm showing that I'm present. I can see myself as present. And for many of us, that's not how we're showing up on Zoom.
That reflection is coming back from a funhouse mirror. It's distorted. It's quite difficult to get any real sense of self from that.
It is. I think you guys are bringing up such excellent points about sort of like this funhouse mirror of self-awareness that we're experiencing. That's the theme that I'm hearing, and I think it's so spot on. I agree with you. Part of the reason I actually think that Zoom meetings are so draining is because we are sort of having to watch ourselves, which in real conversation, we never do. And so it's creating this almost like we're breathing our own exhaust. We're not focusing on other people. You know, I'm doing it right now. I'm like, ooh, does my shot look good? Is my hair okay? And it's just not productive. There's nothing productive in there for us. So one thing that I've actually started doing, other people may have figured this out as well. I just turn off my camera on Zoom meetings. And it doesn't completely bring us back to the way it is when we're all together, but it actually helps a lot.
I think that's part of the reason that Clubhouse is gaining in popularity as well, because it's finally an outlet that's not video, where we can just listen and be a bit more present and not so worried about how's my lighting and how's my view and my angles. And I've been encouraging all of our participants in X Factor and everyone that's in our Zoom coaching groups to turn off self-view. You can hide self-view, so you're just more engaged and focused on the actual conversation and the feedback versus that internal loop that we're getting of, oh, how's my smile? What's this wrinkle in my forehead? All of those things that are just distracting.